Happy morning, dear students. I am your RVR sir. Today in this class, we are going to discuss some of the important model problems on the polarization, particularly on the Brewster's law. In the previous class, we have been discussing the several topics in the polarization unit itself. Those are nothing but Brewster's law, law of Malus, polarization by reflection, polarization by double refraction, production and analyzation of polarized light, Nicol prism, its construction and working, etc. We are already discussed all those things. Now in this class we are going to discuss some of the specific models on the Brewster's law or polarizing angle. Numerical problems on polarization, particularly polarizing angle. Yeah, all of you note down the first problem. When a slab of flint glass, FLINT, flint glass, the angle of polarization is found to be 62 degrees 24 minutes. Calculate the refractive index of the flint glass. I am repeating the problem. All of you note down it carefully. With the slab of flint glass, the angle of polarization is found to be 62 degrees 24 minutes. Polarization angle is 62 degrees 24 minutes. Now, calculate the refractive index of the flint glass. So, given data is polarization angle, we need to find the refractive index. Then, what is the solution for that one? We know that mu equal to tan p. That implies mu equal to tan of 62 degrees 24 minutes. So you have to operate it in your calc. Then its value is comes around 1.9128. Therefore, the refractive index of the flint glass mu equal to 1.9128. This is regarding the first problem. Okay, all of you note down it. Now, we will go for the second problem. A glass plate having refractive index of 1.54. A glass plate having refractive index of 1.54 is used as a polarizer. Find the angle of polarization for it. Find the angle of polarization for it. Also find the angle of refraction. Now look at the given data. Given data is mu equal to 1.54. Then we need to find the angle P equal to how much and angle R is equal to how much. This is our problem. We know that same formula, mu equal to tan p. That implies p equal to tan inverse of mu. Now substitute the value. That is p equal to tan inverse of, what is the value of mu? 1.54. Then if you operate it in our calc, then it will comes around 57 degrees. So, the angle of polarization is given by 57 degrees. And we also know that angle P plus angle R is equal to 90 degrees according to Brewster's law. That implies angle R is equal to 90 minus 57 degrees. Then it will comes around 33 degrees. This is the angle of refraction. All of you note down it. This is regarding the second problem. All of you note down it. Now, note down the third problem. The critical angle for a certain crystal is 45 degrees. What is its polarizing angle? The critical angle for a certain crystal is 45 degrees. What is its polarizing angle? So, given data is C value is given. It is 45 degrees. Then we need to find the P. Angle P equal to how much? That is the problem. We know that mu equal to 1 by sin c. Now substitute the value of c value here. That implies mu equal to 1 by sin 45 degrees. Then its value is comes around root 2. In the sense mu value is, the obtained mu value is 1.414. Now our target is to find the polarization angle. So as mu is already known, we know that mu equal to tan p. That implies p equal to tan inverse of mu. That is tan inverse of 1.414. Then its value is comes around polarization angle P is equal to 54.73 degrees. So this is regarding the angle of polarization. So when the critical angle is given, we need to find the refractive index value using the formula mu equal to 1 by sin c, and then we have to use the formula, Brewster's law formula, that is mu equal to tan p. We will obtain the value of polarization angle. All of you note down it. Okay, after completion of this, we will go for the next problem, that is fourth one. All of you note down the next problem. That is, find the polarizing angle for a glass plate of refractive index 1.732. The refractive index is given. Its value is 1.732. Now we need to find the angle P is equal to how much. We know that mu equal to tan P. Then P is equal to tan inverse of mu. Substitute the value of mu. That is P equal to tan inverse of 1.732. Then its value is around 60 degrees. Therefore, the polarizing angle P is equal to 60 degrees. All of you note down the fourth problem. Now, we will do the similar model problem, one more problem. That is fifth one. All of you note down the fifth problem. The refractive index of water is 1.33. Calculate the angle of polarization for a light reflected from the surface. I am repeating the problem. Note down it, all of you. The refractive index of water is 1.33. Calculate the angle of polarization for light reflected from the surface. Already mu value is given. Its value is 1.33. Then we need to find the polarization angle P value. How much? We know that P is equal to tan inverse of mu. Substitute the value. Tan inverse of 1.33. Then its value is comes around 53 degrees or 53.06 minutes. So this is regarding the polarization angle for the light ray are reflected from the surface of the water. So these are all some of the important problems on this particular polarization angle or Brewster's law. Now note down the last but not least problem, that is regarding the problem on what we call it as Moore's law. Two polarizing layers or sheets having their polarizing directions parallel, so that the intensity of the transmitted light is maximum. Through what angle must either layer be turned or either sheet be turned so that the intensity becomes 1/2 of its initial value? So let us look at the given data. Intensity I is equal to I naught by 2, where I naught is the initial value, and we know that I is equal to I naught cos square theta according to Moore's law. Now if we substitute this, cos square theta value is given by 1/2, then theta value is given by cos inverse of root over 1/2 or 1/√2, which is nothing but plus or minus 45 degrees. Cos inverse of 1/√2 in the sense plus or minus 45 degrees, that means ORR plus or minus 135 degrees also there. Therefore the angle between the two polarizing layers or sheets at which the intensity becomes 1/2 of its initial value is given by theta is equal to plus or minus 45 degrees or plus or minus 135 degrees. Theta is equal to plus or minus 45 degrees or plus or minus 135 degrees. This is how we can solve the important numerical models. Okay, Nandi? All of you note down it. If still you have any doubts, please feel free to ask me when we are in the live class. All of you note down it.